I and welcome to St. Patrick Beale Parish. Our opening hymn can be found in number 564, Come Be Thankful, Kingdom Come, number 564.
To God in the highest. into the hands of each of us, O God, you have entrusted all the blessings of nature and grace. Give us the will and wisdom to multiply the gifts your providence has bestowed. Make us industrious and vigilant as we await your Son's return, so that we may rejoice to hear him say to us, good and faithful servants, and be blessed to enter into the joy of your kingdom. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. The first reading during the last few weeks, we've been trying to capture what is the wisdom of God that flows through everything. And today we have a concrete example that's given to us in the example of a woman who is a good wife and housekeeper, and she's allowing the wisdom of what she has learned to make for a good place for herself and her family. The section that's left out is, it also says that she's a successful businesswoman too. So where do we take the wisdom we've learned from our faith and from God? And in the second reading, Paul is addressing the people who are wondering, when's Jesus coming again? And he says, well, that will be sudden when it comes, but in the meantime, we live in a confidence that Christ is already giving us and the promise of his love for us.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her as an unfailing prize, she brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hands to the distaff and in fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward for her labors and let her words praise her the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm response is number 125. Blessed are those who love you. Number 125.
Oh,
the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you. For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come, like a thief at night. When people are saying, peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness, for that day to overtake you like a thief. For all of you are children of the light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and sober. The word of the Lord.
Good morning. Rosalind. I am here on behalf of Father Roy and the parish leadership. We are grateful to our practitioners for your presence and support for our parish community. I come to you today to try to articulate what you have read from the state of the parish and the school report for fiscal year 2022-2023. Copies of which were distributed at all the masses last week. In addition, we would like to present the results of our disciple maker index survey that was rolled out in February. First, the DMI survey. We appreciate all 131 of you who took the time to participate in our DMI survey, although it presented only 10% of our average weekend mass attendance. We truly value your responses. Of course, we wish the numbers were higher, but it is only through a survey like this that we can objectively know the pulse of the parish better. So, to those who are willing to speak out, we heard, thank you for speaking on behalf of your fellow parishioners, for representing the will and essence of our parish community. Since the survey was from February, some transitions may have already taken place to address some responses. For the most part, this is the framework that we work with. Let's take a look at important points gathered from the survey. We have a brief presentation here, and assisting me with design projection, the slide projection is spread open. The 75 question survey is a tool that invites parishioners to reflect on where they are on their journey of discipleship and enables parish leadership to make data-driven decisions to help parishioners grow in their faith. Questions asked were attitude and beliefs, states in face of their spiritual growth, personal beliefs, parish effectiveness in helping people connect with the community and helping them evangelize. Participation, frequency of parishioners' participation in various parish activities. Relationships, satisfaction, parishioners' satisfaction with their parish, pastor, and various activities. Demographics, gender, age, ethnicity, etc. to understand who is responding. Like I said, there were 131 responses. Perspectives, what the parish needs more. Top three, more young people involved, more volunteers participating in ministries, more clarity on parish vision, direction, and goals. Values that describe the parish culture, access to sacraments and worship, prayerfulness, stewardship. Various facilities, top answers were, we could use some more space, nice boats, but needs some normal step on the renovations or improvements. School, some believe parish and school families are one and the same, believe parish and school families are distinct and believe in the importance of the school, believe we need to build a stronger bridge between school and parish families. Some believe parish and school families are different communities. Financial stability. Don't know enough to answer. Have ups and downs. Shooting for stability. Not a lot of room for experts. Constantly starting to meet needs. In the black, but never complacent. What's working? Key drivers, strongly agree or agree, welcoming community. Parish helps me recognize how God is working in my life, offering vibrant and engaging Sundays, recommend pastor or other priests. Parish support effectiveness, strongly agree or agree, information about parish, easy to find, preaching and promise for that my faith in everyday life. Paris helps me grow spiritually as a Catholic. What's working? It is strongly agreeing or agreeing. Jesus died and rose again. Scripture is the word of God. This Eucharist really is the body and blood of Jesus. In Jesus' moral teaching for my life as taught by the church. Spiritual practices. Monthly or more often. Mass attendance. Individual prayer time. Devotions like rosary, novenas, especially these days. Community, strongly agree or disagree. Transparent information about parish finances, recommend parish. What can we be better? Missionary rules, never or less than one. Inviting someone to priesthood, religious life. Participate in various social events, inviting someone to various activities. Spiritual, never or less than one. Attending a retreat, pastoral counsel, spiritual direction, confession, Eucharistic adoration, growth, lower strongly agree or disagree, music that deepens my desire to participate more fully. Forming me as a disciple of Jesus. So, where do we go from here? We have only shown a concise summary, but these were the elements of the survey. A more in-depth version is available in our website, and this can also be accessed by scanning the QR code sample on the screen. Again, we are grateful to those who participated in the EMI survey. You asked for parish vitality and for evangelization. The parish leadership is committed to using your insights in building a culture of evangelization and is spiritual renewal for our parish. The Gospel of Matthew, sports investing our talents, working diligently in the here and now. Using all the talents God has bestowed upon us, to give glory and honor to Him. We need to act now. As already mentioned, the distributed manual and electronic copies of our state to the parish and school report. We hope you have read this report. We do our best to offer transparency of what happened last week. If you haven't, we hope that when you get home, you will pick up the report or log on to our website and take the time to read through it while you ponder upon what you saw and heard today. We are indeed thankful for our many volunteers that share selflessly not only their treasure but also their time and talents. Parish vitality is the fruit of the hard work of committed volunteers and staff. Case in point is our Faith Formation Commission, who, with the coordinator, the Relief Street Education Volunteer Catechists and AIDS, provide firm and grounded foundation of faith, the Catholic roots of evangelizing our children and their families. Truly, Jesus' parable of the talents in the Gospel of Matthew is an exhortation not just to Jesus' disciples in the past, but also to the present-day followers of Christ, that is us. God bestows on us many different gifts and talents. For this, we are called to use what was given to us to make His kingdom a reality in our community now. Lastly, to kickstart our future evangelization, members of our family are doing formation for evangelization that embodies the spirit of renewal and church. The parish has first invested in a program called FORM. FORM is already being used by our faithful formation as part of their curriculum. It is a great tool for Bible study to watch faith-oriented movies and many more sources. to help me cultivate the soil of your faith, your hearts. Stand with him, you see, in his dream. Also, everyone who has the food and speaks worthy or visit our website to learn more. Let us now pray. Almighty God, we pray that you manifest your presence in our lives, protect our children and our families, and move our parents to the journey of deep relationship with you. Help us build a culture of missionary discipleship together. Cultivate the soil of our hearts. Give glory and honor to you, our God. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you. Again, we can be, hope we are very grateful for all the work that has gone into trying to find your expression of what this parish means, where we can go. Symbolically, of course, we are renovating our windows, our stained glass windows, and that's something that an ongoing possibility for us. Where do we go with our physical plan of the parish? One of the blessings we have in this last year is that our Sunday Mass attendance has gone up significantly. So that's a, there's the raw material we have to work with each other, more people coming. It's a blessing that many parishes would pray for, and we haven't. What do we do with it? That's our challenge. So as we stand now, we appreciate and dedicate ourselves to the faith that draws us together, gives us the generosity to continue making our parish and school and religious education programs vital and growing. So once again, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things, visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified by the Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day, according to the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the glory of the Lord. Amen. Lord, we are always in that ongoing conversation, ongoing prayer with you, which continues now through our petition.
For believers who suffer persecution, and for non-believers seeking truth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a world filled with peace and security, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civilians caught in the midst of war, and for federal members trying to keep peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For belief that what we ask for in faithful prayer we will receive from our loving God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community as we strive to be faithful servants in God's vineyard, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the intentions of this Mass be heard, especially for Melissa A. Martinez, Esusa Apu, and all our parishioners. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, continue to gather us in your name. Empower us with the good news to be lived and shared. This we pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. Again, reminder, after communion, we will have our second collection today, the annual collection for the Catholic Campaign for Human Development, a very practical way of extending our generosity to grassroots organizations, both here in Chicago and around the country. It's a very practical way of putting into action what we try to do, especially in terms of justice. And also, if you're interested in more detail on what are those grants go in the Chicago area, you can, there's a story on that in the Chicago Catholic newspapers, which are available along with the bulletin. So check that out to see very practically what the Catholic Campaign for Human Development accomplishes. Again, thanks. Thank you ahead of time for your generosity for that collection.
Our offertory hymn is number 685, Moved by the Gospel, let us move, 685.
In your Son, by whose disobedience
We have been restored to the gifts of yours, that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. So, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we do give you thanks, as an exaltation we acclaim. And in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, again giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." Then he said, "Do this in memory of me." Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Opening hymn is number 733, We Are Many Parts, number 733.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Father, we have partaken of the gifts of the sacred mystery. Humbly imploring you, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord. Amen. On Thanksgiving morning, this coming Thursday, we will celebrate a bilingual Mass at 9 o'clock. The Mass on Thanksgiving Day will be at 9. All are, of course, invited to gather together. In observance of Thanksgiving, the parish office will be closed on Thursday, Thanksgiving, and Friday, November 24th. It will reopen on Saturday, November 25th at 9 a.m. All of us are invited to join our Vietnamese Catholics to celebrate the Feast of Our Lady of Laban on Tuesday, November 28th, a week from this Tuesday. That Mass will be at 10 in the rather 7 in the evening, with the reception to follow. So you're welcome to attend. Also, our Split the Pot raffle continues to benefit our school. You can get tickets in the chances in the vestibule, as well as you've noticed. We have some Bethlehem art in the vestibule, represented from the Catholic Christian community from Jerusalem and Bethlehem and the Holy Land, are displaying these handcraft goods, religious figurines. We know that due to the political conflict and COVID-19 that now in the recent past there's been a reduction of tourism in Bethlehem. So the families there who have the shops have no business. So it's very difficult for them to survive by taking some of these wood carvings as gifts, or for ourselves, or not only increasing our own devotion, but helping some of our fellow Catholics in Jerusalem and Bethlehem. So look at those wonderful items as we leave church today. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. We have gathered in the parish gifted with so much. We go forth to share that good news. Thanks be to God.
Our recessional hymn is number 678, City of God, number 678.